the first paleontologist must have been going through the area, and aha, all of a sudden they see these huge, like, pyramid structures. Kansas is one of the greatest repositories of life from that time period, 100 million years ago, when the dinosaurs walked the planet. The best place to find fossils from this time period is in what's referred to as monument rocks. And there are these huge things that are sticking up from the plain. I think they are originally referred to as the chalk pyramids. The rock is so soft that you can almost work it out with your hands. And it's just literally packed with fossils. What was discovered or uncovered in those chalk deposits really provided a great window on what life was like back, especially marine life, back during the time when the dinosaurs walked the planet. The purpose of this grant is to take our collections here at KU, we've got literally thousands and thousands of specimens, and make them available in a digital form to scientists and the general public throughout Kansas, the United States, and indeed the world. The history of life does have important lessons for humanity and sort of the long-term prospects for our species and what will help us survive and survive in a world that is better in the future. One of the things that having students and young people around is it really does help the professors move their research forward. But I think it's amazing from a teaching perspective too, because it allows the students to really obtain a hands-on picture of what life might have been like 100 million years ago under an ancient seaway. And we can do that simply by unlocking a cabinet and pulling out a few drawers. To me, I think that's really one of the fascinating things about getting to study fossils. Yeah, I like it from just sort of the curiosity perspective. But a lot of the research that I do focus on sort of looks at how life responds to major changes. And that can help us predict what's happening today and what might happen in the near term over centuries as well.